30 seconds. I don't know how many people will come, but if you did, because this is obviously going to be in a vlog, I appreciate it. And if you didn't, you can catch the replay. It'll be linked somewhere on the screen.
I'm feeling something different when you left. My picture changed. I was blinded. I'd not envisioned the same face in a different frame. It's an omen. Call my baby crying for the silver lining. It must be an omen. Needed you to show me without you I'm lonely. My heart. I didn't pay attention to the light.
afternoon. I put on a sweatshirt because I'm cold. My live stream's been over for an hour now. I'm eating. This is a buffalo chicken pasta bake. But I wanted to update you on what I've been getting done for OctoNoWriMo. Such a stupid name. My live stream went really well. It was really great. We did 4 25-minute Pomodoro sprints, and I ended up getting 2,172 words. That's crazy, y'all. It feels so good to be writing. It feels so good. All of these words have been in my self-indulgent vampire novel, which is just happening. It's just how it is. Yesterday, I think I probably will update you on screen, but I got 1,752 words in an hour and 5 minutes. So I got more words in less time yesterday, but I also wasn't streaming yesterday. As you saw, there was a lot of dancing, a lot of me dancing around, because I'm dorky. But yeah, that is all for today at the moment. It's going great. I have missed drafting so much. And now I'm gonna eat my food and I have class later, so. So I am now in bed. I'll probably be writing. Oh, those are falling off. But I have in fact made you can see my outlining over there. I've made a mistake. I went to Starbucks around like 4 with my mother. She wanted Starbucks. It's Friday, and why not? And yeah, it's 8:34 for context. I might be up for a while. Pray for my heart. Because this is a cold brew. And I did drink a Dr. Pepper too. I don't think I'm ever gonna sleep again. It's so fun. Why am I always freaking brown whenever I spawn? 35 second cooldown for kills? Ugh. Someone named Jesus just popped into the room. See what I am? All right, we're gonna fake going to admin. I was going to sabotage the lights. They stole my thunder. Oh, dead body reported already. Ooh, I actually don't know where I didn't kill anyone. I mean, I didn't kill this person. I am the imposter, but. Oh, they just threw orange out the window. Okay, great. One less person for me to murder. I'm with the other imposter. We could have done a double kill right there, but we didn't.
Oh, okay. Yep.
I'm with black. I saw someone, and luckily it's the other imposter, so. We're gonna sabotage lights again. Black, we could totally do a double kill right there. This other imposter does not like doing double kills, apparently. Ooh, a dead body reported. Ooh, someone's immediately throwing black under the bus. All right, I'm gonna go fix the lights because it'll look sus if I don't. There we go.
We won.
Yes. Ah, there's me. We did it. I killed the last person because Black was just f***ing around. They looked like they were gonna vent. And it's like, you need to not. Anyway, I love Among Us. It's so fun. How are you? Is that better? Maybe? I look a little weird now. Whatever. I don't know how to film make. There we go. Now, if you've been watching my progress and seeing the amount of words that I've written every single day, you'll notice that my progress goes up quite a lot between days. And this isn't because I devote a ton of time to writing. I usually only write for an hour every single day because that's all the time I can spare. That said, I don't want it to come across like I put in all these hours, I get all these words, and I have so much time to devote to my projects. I devote an hour to writing, at least an hour every single day. Granted, some days I do more. However, there's a couple factors that give me the ability to write 17,000 words in an hour, which is a lot, and it's kind of absurd how much that is. There's several things at play here in my writing journey. Number one, I'm an extremely fast typer. I type a lot of words a minute. I know it's hard to tell on the time-lapse clips because they're already fast, so it's kind of hard to tell how long the clip was originally, but trust me, it's pretty fast. I've also outlined this novel, at least a little bit, in my own special way, so therefore I have a place that I can go. I can just spew out tons and tons of words because I know where I'm going and I know what's supposed to happen in the scene and I know where it's supposed to get me to. And the thing that is the biggest thing that I want you to realize about my writing life and my journey is that I spent from the age of 11 to 18, 19 role-playing. The role-playing culture, if you've never role-played before, is a
essentially that you spew out your posts, your responses with your characters, what they're doing, how they're doing it, and you just post it without any editing or anything. And oftentimes you're really excited because someone has responded to you and you get to respond to their post and stuff. So it's really a very creative experience, at least in my opinion. As long as the people you're role-playing with are kind and creative and wonderful and stuff like that, it's important to find yourself a group you're role-playing now. So yeah, that's how I write so fast. That's why I'm an overwriter. Jeez, I could make an entire video on role-playing. So in case you were feeling discouraged or thinking, wow, she writes a lot. I've had a lot of practice, I type really fast, and I outline. Those three things in tandem mean that I often can get lots and lots and lots and lots of words in a very short amount of time. That said, go at your own pace. Don't compare your journey to mine. My advice for writing faster, write a lot. So that's why I write so fast.
As time passes, I feel so low, searching for peace.
So I have to stand because I've literally been sitting in a chair all day and it's not good for my back or my body, but I'm standing.
Today's October 4th. So today I wrote
13,000 words.
Yeah, 13,000, 1300 words,
which is
fantastic. That is
what I had on my chart to get. I think I'm now at over 7,000 words, which is great. I'm on a really great pace. I'm really loving the story. I'm having such a fun time with it. I just want this story to be out so that I can talk about it with other people. Because right now I'm just like raring to talk about it and I can't. The only information I'll give you is that I'm currently referring to this plot line as be gay, solve crime. That's the gist of what plot we're working with. Be gay, solve crime.
Yeah, so I'm going to
move my body a little bit more. I'm like out of breath, which is so bad. I've also been like jumping around and trying to warm up these creaky bones. So yeah, so I will check in with you tomorrow.
For your soul, I throw all of my cares away for you. I'll be there to wait for you. Maybe you weren't the one for me, but deep down I wanted you to be. I'll still see you in my dreams. All the things that I did for you just wasn't it for you. So I'll be coasting, I'm roller coasting through my emotions. I will be coasting, roller coasting. I'm hoping that you come back to me. Moving on seems harder to do when the one that you love moves faster than you. I gave you my all, I showed the proof, realizing you weren't worthy. You don't deserve me. As time passes, I'm feeling high. You're not the one I'm thinking of tonight. I may not be over you, but I'll try inside. I'm feeling better now, finally feeling special now. I'm coasting, I'm roller coasting through my emotions. Oh, I will be, yeah.
Hello. Writing has been going surprisingly well. Welcome to my car, by the way. It is one of those days where I'm questioning whether pursuing writing is a worthy endeavor, which is a strange thing to be considering at 11 a.m. But nonetheless, here we are. I definitely think some of the pressure is internal and compounded by the fact that it's hard to know whether you are good at something, especially something as subjective as writing, especially when you are terrified to let people see it. So that's a thing. I'm graduating soon, so obviously I'm having existential crises about that. Crises, but I talked to my therapist recently about what I could do as a job, and we went through like this career matchmaking thing. Number one was artist, which, you know, writing is an art. Writer was 10. I just think writing is the only thing in the moment that feels fulfilling and satisfying and worthy of time.
That's horrible.
It's the truth, but it's incredibly difficult to make a living off of writing. Most likely whatever I pursue creatively, whether it's YouTube, writing, I'll have to have a second job unless I become crazy, wild, unicorn successful, which is rare and will... I can't bank on that, essentially. I'm not gonna say it's never gonna happen because, you know, positivity. But at the same time, you have to be realistic. And realistically, I have to plan for the fact that I might not have the crazy wild success that would allow me to live off of my own writing. At least not for many years. And it takes a while to build up a substantial following and such. That's like the realistic side of writing that I'm thinking about because as I'm drafting again the self-indulgent vampire novel, I'm thinking about how much I really, really love writing and how it makes me so fucking happy. And all I want to do is write. For right now, those are my thoughts as an unemployed college student. Sorry to get all Debbie Downer on you in this clip, but those are some things I'm thinking about. I need to go get gas, so let's get a move on.
Hello, friends. It is currently October 7th, and I have some announcements for you. So first, I just want to say that we are very close to having 200 subscribers on this channel. I can't believe how fast I've grown and how much fun I've been having creating content, talking to you guys.
So,
I think when I hit 200 subscribers, I'm going to be doing a Q&A. I will put up a video for that, but if you haven't already, make sure you hit that red subscribe button so you never miss a post, especially if you like listening to my rambling face. Just snuck that plug in there. In really exciting news, this month I am participating in the World Ride Write-a-thon. I am so excited. It is hosted by Jessica Williamson. I will have all of her socials linked down below if you'd like to check her out. And of course, I would encourage you to come check out the World Ride Write-a-thon. It is a 36-hour write-a-thon where we relay sprints, one on each of the channels, and we'll be doing live sprints for 36 hours. And then there's also chats. So I will leave the link to that down below. I'm one of the hosts. I'm going to be on there with
Great Fry, Steak, and Wallace. I have all of their things here.
I'll have the live stream playlist linked down below, so you definitely don't want to miss that. Very excited to be participating. My stream personally is going to be at 2:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Saturday, October 10th. So in 3 days since I'm filming this, 2 days since you've seen it. So you still have some time to get ready. I'm going to be attempting a 10K, so you should come along for my ride as I try to write 10,000 words in 36 hours. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a like. It really helps my channel and tells me that you're liking my vlog content. I hope you have a wonderful day wherever you are, whenever you are, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!